I was diagnosed over 5 years ago with metastatic breast cancer. I went to my doctor and I said I had a cyst in my breast, and he felt it and he was like, oh, don't worry about it, you're really young. If it feels like it's growing a lot, then come back, but just keep an eye on it.
After a year, Carrie returned to find the lump was a cancerous tumor and that it had spread to her liver, making her a stage 4 cancer patient.
If you're discovered later stage, it's somehow your fault, like you did something wrong, you weren't paying attention, or you didn't follow the either norms of doing self-checks or whatever. I thought that I did all the things right, like I went to my doctor, I exercised, I ate healthy, and it just didn't turn out the way it should.
Because the cancer had spread throughout her liver, surgical removal was not an option.
So I did a hormonal treatment that turned off my ovaries so that I no longer produced estrogen. And then I went on a different pill for a year. And then after that, I didn't have any more pill options. And that's when I ended up on IV chemotherapy, where I lost my hair and all of that. That was very hard, because once you lose your hair, you really can't pretend you don't have cancer.
Carrie's treatments cleared the tumor in her breast, but the spots in her liver persisted, pushing her to seek other treatment options.
As a cancer patient, I have to be an advocate for myself, and I have to do my research and find out what's the best next thing for me that's going to work well. My husband had forwarded me an article that he'd found about histotripsy, this new treatment that they were doing clinical trials on.
Developed by University of Michigan engineers, histotripsy is a non-invasive cancer treatment that uses ultrasound waves to break up tumor cells. 2 decades in the making, it wouldn't exist today without the perseverance of biomedical engineering professor Zhen Zhu and her team.
Histotripsy actually uses microsecond ultrasound pulses to activate the nanometer gas pockets in our body and then generate microbubbles and make the microbubbles expand and collapse within very short time frame. And that creates very high mechanical strain and stress to disrupt the disease cells, such as the tumor cells.
What you get is a procedure that won't make patients sick or damage healthy tissue, which for people like Carrie is a relief from years of aggressive treatment. In 2022, she took part in the Hope for Liver clinical trials at Michigan Medicine.
I was thinking, this is really great, especially for someone like me, where it's just cancer in the one place that keeps coming back in the one place.
As a radiologist who specializes in cancer treatment, it is not infrequent where I am sitting reading an MRI or CT and see very young patients with very advanced cancer. And so patients like Carrie, who've already tried other treatment options and still have cancer, to me, those are the patients where you just want to do anything you can to help them out.
Carrie's tumors were treated using a robotic device developed by U of M spinoff Histosonics. The procedure starts with putting the patient under anesthesia and positioning the treatment head over their abdomen to locate the tumor. Once located, clinicians lock onto the tumor to emit the sound waves and break up the diseased tissue. It's fast and painless, with many patients wondering if anything was even done at all.
I woke up, felt fine. I think it was either the next day or the day after that, I went to the Henry Ford Museum and like walked around. I was okay, like got on a plane, came home, went back to work. Like I didn't have any like long-term like soreness or pain or anything that you would like expect from having had a procedure on your liver.
An MRI immediately after the procedure showed the treatment was effective. And after a year of follow-ups, the treated tumors were completely destroyed, with no recurrent disease in the treated areas.
It was so cool. It's like that little parasite got killed. You know, it's like a little thing is dead there. There's nothing there anymore.
It's outcomes like Carrie's and other clinical trial patients that have awarded Histosonics with FDA approval to sell their tech to hospitals, bringing histotripsy to cancer patients worldwide.
It's a really exciting new technology that I hope really becomes more available to everybody. And I hope it's something that people can do repeatedly, like, because that's one of the problems with a lot of these interventional treatments is that you can't do them very often. Either they're too expensive or they cause too much damage.
Everything outside is still intact.
I'm just really excited to see histotripsy used in a wider patient population. This will allow us to extend histotripsy in the future for other applications such as renal tumor, pancreatic tumor, or even beyond the cancer, such as neurological applications and the cardiovascular applications.
In addition to non-invasive treatment, early data from rodent studies and the trials are showing that when the body is cleaning up the tumor fragments from histotripsy, it forms an immune response.
So as the blood flows towards this area, all the immune cells come and they recognize what we say, the antigen or something foreign in this area, and they create antibodies, kind of stimulate an immune response. Now let's say we treat something in the liver and you have a mass in your lung, this antibody can go to the lung and fight the lung tumor.
Hopefully we can then combine histotripsy with immunotherapy or drug delivery so that we can now expand histotripsy from a local ablation tool into a potential tool that can treat tumors globally in all over the body and eventually into a cure.
Over a year after histotripsy, the approach proved effective, but Carrie isn't cancer-free. Additional tumors continue to grow in the untreated areas of her liver, but she hasn't given up.
When you have this like major life derailment, it kind of forces you to put into perspective what's important. And for me, I want to live my life. I want to continue to live my life, and I'm not ready to give up. And that's just kind of what keeps me going, is the idea that, yeah, maybe I have an advanced cancer, but maybe I can still contribute to the world, and maybe I can still manage to beat it somehow if I can just stick around long enough.